The Anduril firmware continues to receive updates over time. The new features are great, but if you don't follow these things, you might be left very confused upon trying out new hardware configurations, like I was with the M44 and D2. The capabilities and operation of multi-channel lights have changed quite a bit since I last talked about it. You can now set your light to easily switch between individual channels, smooth tint ramping, auto tint, and locked channel mix with a simple triple press. Or you can disable some or even all of these modes and just use the settings you prefer, and even customize those settings. This scales with the number of channels, so some lights, like the triple channel MSRs, have a ton of modes. To change available modes, press 9 times and hold on the last press. This will enter the Extras menu, which will cycle between the various modes. Release on a mode and the light will begin buzzing or flashing rapidly. Press once to enable the mode, or do nothing to disable the mode. And that's it. While the light is on, a simple triple press will cycle between the available modes. 3H from there will ramp between channels on the relevant modes, or will activate momentary turbo on the static modes. This can be annoying if you forget that you're not on a ramping mode, and attempt to change the temperature only to accidentally blast turbo instead, so keep that in mind. Normally, 3 presses will cycle between stepped and smooth output ramping for the actual light source. When multiple channel settings are enabled, it will instead cycle modes, and 6C will adjust output ramp style. If you have only a single channel mode enabled, such as tint ramping, then 3C will revert to its original function. This can be confusing, so be aware of that. My MSR D2 has a 519A on channel 1 and a UV emitter on channel 2. Naturally, these two don't make sense running together, so I just disabled everything except for channels 1 and 2, and I just use it as a straight dual channel light. Meanwhile, my M44 has just the smooth tint ramping enabled, because that's all I want out of this light, and I kept accidentally turboing myself with 3H because I thought it was on smooth tint ramping, so that was annoying. Finally, in my Workos HD10 and TS10V2 review, I talked about the phantom channel issue I experienced with those lights where they thought the aux emitters were separate main channels. If you encounter this, it can be fixed by going through the process and disabling all of the channels except for the actual main emitters. With this firmware, if you go to the Extras menu and just keep holding the button after it cycles through the main channel settings, it will then cycle through all of the different auxiliary colors. You can even take advantage of this if you wanted and keep the red aux on, and use it as a red channel, so silver lining, I guess. It's time-consuming and annoying to have to do this, and to have to limit the ceiling for the TS10 output, but it does display the power of Anduril in allowing you to fix these problems and customize the light. Though, manufacturers should just configure their lights properly to begin with. One bonus thing, I mentioned the new smooth steps in my D3AA review. If you're not a fan of that, it can be disabled. 10H will enter the ramp extras menu, and doing nothing on the fifth item will disable the smooth steps, while a single press will re-enable the feature. And that's all. Hopefully this little guide was helpful to somebody. I will link below the official manual for Anduril 2 and Toykeeper's Patreon, where you can support her for all of the work put into this awesome project. Okay, goodbye.